freeway, you know. And I did reactivate my cell phone for the drive back because I was on the phone with lawyers and counselors. Multitasking. No, it was a month he let me go early. I completed early. I had met all their requirements. And the day that I was leaving home, or leaving there to come home, two pods were in my driveway to pack up my stuff. He was going to have my house boxed. And God made it so I showed up before that could happen. Mm-hmm. And I was in that house for 3 years. The divorce was civil for the most part. We have joint custody. The kids are adapting. But my encouragement would be, let God lead. Because I thought I had all the answers. I really did. I wanted this particular ending to a story. And I wasn't about to let it go until I had that ending. And God kept trying to pry it from my fingers, but I wouldn't let it go. And then finally, I just released it because I realized, you know what? Where I am and where he is, we're not on any even playing field anymore. Not that we couldn't be, because I know where God can take a person to and how quickly it can happen.
Oh, sure.
Provided on surrender. But I remember giving it all to him. Just giving it all. I took all the pictures that we had, he and I, the wedding pictures, the thing that I wore when I got married. It wasn't a wedding gown. It was just something appropriate to wear. And I burned them. And it wasn't in anger, and it wasn't in hate. It was like a sacrifice. Lord, here are all the memories, the cards, everything. Here, I give this to you because I know if you bring it back, it can never be based on what it was. It would have to be completely new.
I commend you because you are burning the semblance of your past, of your pain, of your hurt.
But and my question thought came was, you know, you were talking about your kids in the house, but what kind of mom do they have now?
That's the amazing part. My kids have a mother that does not take for granted being a mother. Something I had done. One more child to take care of, one more dish to do, more laundry, everything piling up. I find myself pouring love into my children like I never could before. They know Jesus. Three of my five have been born again. They have a connection with God. They know that their mother loves to worship. And I do. I love to worship God. And that all came from such brokenness. Because had I not been broken, I wouldn't be who I am now. If I hadn't gone through each and every one of those things, God even used my broken marriage. The things that Satan meant to condemn me with, God was just lifting me up with all of it. Mm-hmm. He was going to bring me to a level and a place I could never imagine, nor could I ever get to without the brokenness.
I like what you said, that he had to pry that out of your hands.
He did. Mm-hmm. It was
Mike
a wrestling match.
All the time, you know, we've had that conversation with God that I'm going to give you this, 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 and this, but I'll take care of this. Mm-hmm. I got this. Mm-hmm. And finally, he says, all right, you got that. And then he just squeezes you till he gets it all.
Right. And what it was fear. Fear mm-hmm. to relinquish it because I felt, well, what
fear
if you...
control.
Right,
and
losing
failure.
That?
Nobody wants to epically fail. You know,
but I didn't want to be told it wasn't coming back
right.
either. Like I was going to lose this for good.
Sure.
And that was my fear. So in my mind, I was holding on to it, wrestling God for it, and he won.
He always does.
I know. But I can tell you, the journey, I have met more people. I mean, God has placed them in waves in my life, and then me in other people's lives as they come. I'll meet somebody that's just starting off in a divorce or had an affair or there's something and they need encouragement. And God just brings those people. And, you know, when you meet another believer, they're not just a fellow believer. They become your brother, your sister, and your family just expanded.
I'd like to ask, do you know what your spiritual gift is?
I don't know for sure yet.
Okay.
I know I have a lot of compassion. I can weep with those who weep and laugh with those who laugh. I know that. Encouragement.
Encouragement is exhortation.
Yep.
That's why I ask, because it sounds like it. But
absolutely.
It yeah.
Yeah. I did do a class at Mosaic, and I have the gift of mercy when we did the little charts and came out the gift of mercy, which was surprising to some. I don't know why. That may be insulting. I don't know why they thought that.
Anything's possible when you're just totally clean.
But it is. It does say in the Bible that you should be equally yoked with your mate. And what I've seen over the past 7 years, even the slightest difference, even both Christians, and one is here, up here, and one is down, halfway down, there is still going to be a between each other. It's got to be equally yoked. And I've been praying for that for 7 years now. Mm-hmm. Equally yoked.
Right. I have too. I also want to make this point because I used to beat myself up so much about this. And sometimes I still do. I'm not, you know. I think sometimes our perception of ourselves as Christians is skewed. Sometimes I think that we believe we have to have it all together, that we're going to walk it flawless. Well, see, now I have Jesus, so I don't make any mistakes. And I feel like I've made more mistakes, hit more walls, stumbled around blindly, going, wow, I know that I'm supposed to do this, and yet I still do this. But Christianity doesn't mean I'm perfect.
Yeah.
It just means I get back up.
Some people think that, though.
Right, and that is wrong. It's really wrong.
It is.
Well, Paul said that before we did.
He did, Paul. Paul,
why do
Bible,
I do the things
you
I don't
want to
do?
And,
right.
Romans 7. It's...
And that's why we're covered in grace.
Coming from Paul, that, you know, you would think, and a Christian would think Paul is probably one of the strongest and most devout Christians and so on, and met God, and he wrote the words in Romans 7. I do what I don't want to do, and I can't stop it, and I do and I don't do, and it's just...
It's powerful. And I can tell you each year I grow stronger, and my kids see it, and they see the balance, and they know... Their mama prays for them. Every night my son comes up to me and says, Mom, and he will hound me incessantly.
Good for him.
Pray for me. Mom, I want you to pray for me. There are times when, you know, you feel it. Things are going on and it's just like, I'll say, that's it. We're praying. And we stop and we pray. And then things come back into order. Because I've learned to take that authority. And God has really given me the grace to be that spiritual leader. Something I didn't ever think I could do. You know, 4 years ago, I was falling apart.
You can't unless you have him.
Exactly.
Right. And, you know, during my walk, you know, I believed, you know, I put two wives on a pedestal. And I did. I lived for them pretty much. And I always thought they were my best friends and so on. And then I started to walk with God, and then I said, now how can I call her when she comes my best friend, because Jesus is my best friend? And what I saw, what I read in a book that was given to me, that when the husband puts God first, and then the husband herself puts God first, everything secondary comes into place.
And that's the way it should be.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't understand that concept at all. My priorities had always been skewed. And same with my husband at the time. You know, I'm praying that it eventually we'll be able to be friends. You know, where it's friendly. I mean, we're getting to that place.
Yeah.
And that's my heart's
good
desire.
Right.
I don't want tension. I don't, because you know what? The kids don't deserve any more brokenness. They don't. I love my children more than life itself. Mm-hmm. And there's nothing I would not do for them.
Amen.
In fact, I did. And I hope they look back and see how much I did love them by going to Teen Challenge and by doing that, the sacrifice.
That,
oh, they will.
They will.
Oh, my gosh, yes.
They will.
I mean, I know
they
it's young now.
That.
My oldest daughter, I'm completely estranged from right now because I left.
Happened.
I know. And God promised me he was going to heal it. And I'm
my youngest daughter, the same thing.
Right.
Yeah. I'm kind of going through that with my oldest son as well, but
it'll happen.
It will.
God promises that he
will
restore.
Absolutely. You know, Jessica, I just am so touched by this. We typically don't close the show with prayer, but I just feel led to ask you if you would,
sure.
Especially just pray for our listeners out there.
Right.
I just feel a presence right now, just an anointing on the program I can't describe.
Absolutely.
In this room. So if you just pray for the listeners, and we'll close it up. And thank you so much for coming.
Thank you for having
sharing
me.
Your story.
Thank
it's,
you.
It's going to be amazing.
I'm
looking
speechless.
Forward to getting the feedback and just sharing it
yeah,
with you.
Yeah.
And
definitely.
Would you be willing to answer questions? If
absolutely.
Some of the listeners had
absolutely.
Questions about.
I would. I'd even meet with them if they wanted to.
Sure. There may be some listeners. I mean, there'll be people downloading this all over the world. So. We have a blog set up and whatnot, so there may be some questions that may come in, and I'll just get those to you. That'd
I would
be
absolutely
wonderful.
Be more than happy to, because fantastic. I know what God did for me.
Amen.
And he can do for anybody.
Amen.
All right, give us that prayer.
Okay.
For those women and anybody else that needs to hear this.
Dear Father God, I just praise you and I thank you for this opportunity to come and share my testimony, Father. Lord, I thank you for taking just the broken pieces in me and making them whole. For giving me beauty from those ashes. Father, I know that there are many, many people out there, men, women, children, teenagers. They're hurting, Father. They're broken. They don't know where to go. They don't know where to turn. Father, I pray that they hit their knees and they cry out to you just as I did, Father God. You promise that you're there. You're close to the brokenhearted. Jesus, your hand can touch and heal so many wounded, broken souls. All they have to do is cry out to you.
Heard folks whisper.
Father, I ask for your mercy, your grace. Anyone struggling right now, I lift them up to you. There's been so much death, destruction, turmoil. But Father, you promised to be there in those times. You never promised a life without storms and turmoil. But Father God, you have promised to walk us through them. You will boldly walk us through them, Father God. We don't have to fight these battles. You fight them for us. The victory is already won. We just need to trust you in it. Father, I thank you for all that you're doing. Continue to pour your love out on your children. You know where each and every one of them are at all times. Continue to put people in their paths, Father God, that will speak truth, encourage them towards you. And I pray, Father, that whoever doesn't know Jesus, that they will come to know him. Not only as Savior, but as Lord and best friend. I thank you for the opportunity to be here with you. Mike and Fritz, it was truly a blessing to me. And Father God, anytime I pray, I always lift up my children. I ask that you continue to cover them, Father God. Protect their minds, their hearts, their souls, their spirits, and their bodies. Keep your angels surrounding them, protecting, guiding. I just praise you. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Amen. Thank you again, Jessica.
You're welcome.
This show will be posted on godstoriesradio.com tomorrow, so check us out, www.godstoriesradio.com. Please feel free to hit the blog. Email us at godstoriesradio@gmail.com. Friend us on Facebook and Twitter at God Stories Radio. We're also on Stitcher Radio now, and iTunes has picked us up. So we're out there. There's a lot of different venues and avenues you can pick us up on. But the biggest thing is we want to hear from you. So if these shows are touching your life, we've got no other agenda.
Right. Encourage us.
Encourage us as well, and let us know, hey, that show is amazing. And if you have any questions, if there's any ladies out there that have any questions for Jessica, just send us an email.